Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto Vice City. I'm the mysterious JG. One way to make sure you don't have to worry about copyright strikes is to do fire truck missions the entire time, firefighter missions. But that's over. In silence style 911? I don't know what the in silence part's
Yo,
about.
why are you all up there? Happening here?
But in this case, the firefighter missions are done. I'm not going to try any more for right now. We have assassination missions. Those are never mandatory to the plot. I'll come back and do them eventually. But again, seeing as they're not mandatory to the story, well, I actually like this song because this is playing. I don't know what the lyrics are. I don't speak or understand Spanish really, but I just like this song, so I'll keep it on. And we'll see if it becomes our next Neun und Neunzig Luftballon. If it does, I'm not going to try to sing it because usually I can pronounce German words. I would not, based upon reading them on a page, know how to pronounce Spanish words. But anyway. I took German in high school, so I know I understand most of the pronunciation rules. I'm sure I pronounced some words wrong from reading Neun und Neunzig Luftballons. But German, like most other languages, does not have anywhere near as many irregular verbs and irregular pronunciations as English does. Like if a German, I'm not going to go off into something about how, oh, this befits Germans who are so structured and disciplined. But like the German language is very much like there is a set of rules that is followed, and there's a handful of irregular verbs and stuff. Like there are irregular verb forms for like the verb for to be, like the most ancient of ancient words, but like anything developed, yeah, it's not like English, where they have regular verbs and irregular verbs, but like 80% of verbs are regular verbs anyway. My point is, I took German in high school, and therefore, if I see an I and an E back to back, I know that it's pronounced like a long E. 90% of the time, and if it's not pronounced that way, it's probably a word that came from another language. That's really it. That's all I'm trying to get to. I'm also killing time as we drive around, talking over the song in case it does deliver a copyright strike. Now, this is not really an epic sports car to be driving up to the Colonel's yacht in to show him what a like successful, rich businessman I am, but at least I'm listening to Latin music. Maybe he'll appreciate that. Then again, there's enough different Latin music. It'd be like, that guy speaks English, I'll listen to country. That will mean we will be connected. He might hate this genre of Latin music.
I'm a VIP, and I want to live around people just like myself. Rich and divorced.
Shady Acres.
I'm Everett Carey.
This is, I've got more voice acting going into this commercial than potentially the entire mission string I'm on. That's Burt Reynolds, by the way. I have a mustache. Did you know that? You probably didn't. I have a mustache, and so did Burt Reynolds. We're both cool. Anyway, moving along here.
Not only do you get a luxurious 5,000 square foot condo with underground parking.
So, hopefully that's not still there when I'm trying to leave after having started this mission. But what was I getting at a minute ago? I'll just have this when I write up so that I'll look and sound cool. I'm not gonna look that cool. I'm dressed for golf. I had a train of thought I was on that I've completely lost. But anyway, I'm gonna pretend this is the chainsaw he gave me, even though we have our own chainsaw that spawns outside of our hotel room. Oh, Guardian Angel Tatsuna. Oh, I didn't mean to do the new seat covers.
Diaz has asked me to oversee a minor business transaction.
Let's hope it goes better than last time.
Which is why I thought of you, my friend. I've dropped some protection at the multi-story car park. Pick it up, then go and watch over Diaz's man at the drop-off. Gracias, amigo.
Diaz, huh? Apparently that angry midget runs this madhouse. Let's
it's
see what that creep has to do with things.
It's a madhouse. So, I'm still paranoid that I'm going to lose my Uzi. That I spent all this money on. Because what I got is the cheapest Uzi that's available, because it's the only one you're allowed to buy right now. But, I can keep it on New Wave. I just need to be listening for Blondie's Atomic so that I can immediately change the station. Or Neun and Neunzig Luft Balloon itself, because as soon as I hear it, I'm like, okay, well, switch. Because the game is not going to have... I'm going to have to use the YouTube processor to remove the song, but it's probably easier if there's less of the song to be removed. But there's some really good songs on the rock station. A lot of music I really like in this game as a period piece, but I mean, the most 80s feeling of these stations for me is the New Wave station. So it's the car park, so I don't remember exactly. The golf suit's kind of silly. Let's get back into the clean clothes. This is a cool suit. It makes me feel like a Miami Vice guy. And since I just happen to be here, we'll put it on. So I got to figure out where the entrance is to the car park. It's somewhere on this block, I would assume. Here we go. I think this will be a different gun slot.
Hogging all the action, I see.
Oh, now you're back, because it's a plot mission.
Other than just shadowing me everywhere, why don't you come along and show me if you're any use?
Why don't you help me put out some fires?
The name's Lance, by the way.
Tommy Vercetti. Let's go.
You got a last name, Lance? I guess I can choose which car I want to use, but we'll use his white Lamborghini. Kruger and assault rifles allows you to manually aim in first person. I was gonna fuck up your car, Lance. I hope that's okay. Press and hold R1 button and aim with an assault rifle. Unlikely I'll remember that. I'll probably treat it the same as every other gun. Well, maybe, yeah. R1 to aim. Isn't R1 fire with any other gun? I don't even remember. I think circle is always fire. I wasn't using guns at all in the last two videos, really, so I haven't actually fired off a gun in this particular sit-down recording session yet. But obviously we'll be doing it here. He didn't give us a gun so that we could go listen to a plot scene where we don't use a gun. Someone is going to interfere with this deal, and we're going to take them out. And I think, I don't know why I would be spoiling the story, but I think this is it. It's like, we do these missions for the colonel. If I touched that cop car, who'd like turned around that corner like that blind, I would have gotten a one-star wanted level, by the way. Not that I was in the right lane for traffic to be legally in, but I was trying to get around an accident, so. Yeah, but I think this might be where we start getting involved with Diaz, doing missions for him.
You must be Cortez's new gun.
Until more gainful opportunities arise. He'll be here any minute. We both better get a good vantage point.
Okay, I'll take the balcony. You get the roof across the yard.
Because I can teleport towards a balcony. Because you are not going to be able to go indoors. Here come the Cubans. Watch over the deal-making and make sure Diaz and Lance are safe. The other two guys aren't plots, so don't worry about them. Okay, so where... Boop!
I say no to that, man.
Press the L3 button to duck. But I can't see the,
I'm next in line, man.
I can't see a target reticule. Oh, there it is. Okay, so something...
picando, tío.
Okay, that was kind of a problem because fucking... That was the Haitians. Yeah, there's a little bit of a problem there on account of, the vantage point they gave me, I was standing on, I couldn't fucking shoot. From up here, it was like, oh, no, like, apparently, R1 to aim, wasn't it? No, yeah, R1. Yeah, they gave me this vantage point where I was like, oh, I'm supposed to use this, maybe it was my fault. It's not clear to me whether or not I could have shot. Okay, I could have shot. It was my fault. Yeah, I was trying to do what they told me to do, and I kept getting into this situation where it was like, I thought I was too close to the edge to fight. Oh, I'll run you over. Just as a proof that this thing works. Okay, well, the aim is fucking terrible anyway. I'm still better off. Just, yeah, I think I'm still better off just, like, getting down there on that ground level and well, anyway. Okay, that wasn't exactly a rip-roaring success. Let's get back to the hotel. We lost a tiny, tiny bit of armor.
I just love the batter all over my face. On Friday nights, I just can't stop.
But yeah, quality of life issue. Grand Theft Auto 5, I would get the opportunity to just restart from that mission point, a checkpoint. In this game, it's like, if the mission takes place really close to the point where you would initiate the mission, it's not that big of a deal. Other than the fact that you got to do all the mission steps in one sequence. You can't be like, I did the first part of the mission and then failed and now I have to go to the mid-mission checkpoint. It's more about, like, you start a mission on the West Island and then drive all the way to the East Island to actually do the mission, or the plot teleports you to the East Island. You fail, now you've got to get across the entire game map to reinitiate the mission. A little quality of life thing. But a clever, clever monkey, who is really just being a huge cheapskate since I now have $26,000. But if you were just being a huge cheapskate, you could just keep initiating that mission, getting that gun, failing the mission, and getting free ammo for an assault rifle. Though it's probably a low-end assault rifle. Like, pretty much every Wappet in this game, there are multiple tiers, and the first one or two that you get introduced to in the game will be kind of shit. I've also got a nice supply of that pistol ammo saved up, and it's the best pistol in the game, I think. The ones that you actually get as a reward for hidden packages or doing missions is usually pretty good. So that mission actually also served as our... Okay, as far as I know, we haven't heard this song yet, so this may be a copyright strike, but I guess I'll find out. Yeah, these are not tables that can be knocked over. They are permanent fixtures. And this game does a good job with giving you lots of things to interact with in the world that can be knocked over, but like... You could be in a Hunter, which is their Apache helicopter, which will appear much later in the game, firing missiles down. It's not going to affect the palm trees. They are immortal, and similarly, those tables cannot be harmed by normal human items. All right, let's try this again. But I think this is the end for Cortez for a while. I think once we've done these Cortez missions, because you saw that little bit of dialogue introducing ourselves to Diaz, I think we start getting involved in the Diaz storyline. as Tommy said, not just, you know, Tommy to Diaz talking about doing missions for Diaz as a gainful employment opportunity, but as he says in his own eternal dialogue, figuring out where Diaz fits into this picture. Because at this point, we're still trying to figure out who our friends are and our enemies are. It could turn out that Diaz, or Cortez for that matter, probably not Avery, who doesn't seem to be involved with the drugs. Interesting, no wanted level for that. Maybe the cop recognized that it was his fault. I don't know, but you need her and she needs you. You need her and she needs you. You need her and she needs you.
Flash.
She loves to get Flash.
The real action is right here, baby, on Flash with me.
I can't imagine that's how the song ends.
Honestly,
they just kind
the radio
of
since music.
Totally tubular. Anyway, yeah, Diaz, Cortez, Avery seems to be involved in real estate, not drugs. But most of the characters we've been, including Lance, most of the characters we've been interacting with could be the people who actually set us up, and we don't know it yet.
Hogging all the action, I see.
I don't know why I'm being so impatient. I was in a video description for another video talking about how it's kind of fun that they give you an ally like Lance, but he only shows up sporadically. Okay, so R1 to aim, then the left trigger, you can't run around while you have it equipped, I guess. The left trigger is what moves the reticule, because I was using the R trigger and not getting a reticule. That's where I was so confused. The R stick is usually the one that would kind of move your camera around, although it's a little janky, but this is a... Was this PS1 or PS2? This is PS2. It had an R. It had a left and right joystick, I think. Thumbstick. This is not a song I would normally go out of my way to listen to, but it's so much fun to have it pop up in the middle of your 80s adventure.
This is the lead killer here.
One of my sisters are down. Lance really shouldn't be happy with how I'm treating his car either. I don't know if I can skip this one. I definitely don't have the ability to pause these.
No more gainful opportunities arise. They'll be here any minute. We both better get a good vantage point.
Okay, I'll take the balcony. You get the roof across the yard.
All right. Cubans are our allies. Haitians are going to show up. They came from over here.
We are in big time, man.
That's right, man. It's another car. Where the hell am I? Ah. Well, at least that time I knew what I was. I knew how what I was supposed to be doing. Well, I knew what I was supposed to be doing all along, but.
You are treading deep water. Control yourself.
So that's a better Uzi than the one I've been using.
Where am I?
But I don't have the ability to get more of it, so right now I want to stick with the Uzi I had. Okay, well, here you go. So I keep failing this mission, but at least now I know the controls. It was just... Honestly, I don't like the first person aiming around. It's a lot simpler for me to use any other gun. So I think what we'll do is, even though they gave us an automatic, like an assault rifle... Which I get, I'm sure it has more stopping power to the extent that that matters in this game. But you shoot somebody up with an Uzi or or an assault rifle. Oh, that person was trying to rejack the car. Like, you saw her reaching for the, like, she was trying to pull me out of the car and dump me on the street the same way I did to her. And I applaud her. I am glad I didn't end up killing her in that transaction because she's got some balls. She got lady balls. I always appreciate lady, well, I don't know. And then you see a video about some woman calling the cops on, like, a kid who's selling lemonade without a permit. I don't appreciate those lady balls, but, yeah, you steal something from her and she's like, I'm gonna freaking fuck you up and steal it back. That's pretty cool. Alright, but here we go. Again, one of the things about Vice City that, I mean, you can argue it makes the game too easy. There's no punishment for failure in GTA 5. GTA 5, literally, you'll reach a point where it's like, you want to just continue the story without doing this mission? Which is, I think, a bit much. But, that, you know, giving a little sting to failure gives it more teeth. But, yeah, the, like, okay, can I just go retry that without having this much work to do is a little annoying in the earlier Grand Theft Auto games. Grand Theft Auto 3, I feel like I failed the last mission is a really fairly long mission. There's quite a few things you need to do right with limited time. And every time you fail, you have a really long trek back to the point where that mission initiates. So I have memories of, I never actually beat Grand Theft Auto 3, I think. I got to that last mission and never beat it. And I feel like there's tougher missions in the Grand Theft Auto series than the final mission of Grand Theft Auto 3. It doesn't stick in my head like, you know, Omega at the end of Brood Wars or anything like that. But, you see, there should be a helicopter there. I think you got to reach a certain point in the story before it starts spawning. But that's really preventing me from getting quite a few hidden packages that are not really second island hidden packages. I pursue Happy Island hidden packages. Just so that he knows who I am, you know. They open that gate and let me into the yacht. When they hear the sound of that chainsaw, and they know that it's me. Alright, I keep skipping his portion, but I can't skip Diaz's. It's like I'm favoring Diaz over Cortez. I actually find Cortez to be, like, he's supposed to be this, like, dictator who's, like, really charming and genteel, but, like, underneath, he's probably, like, a fucking dangerous monster. Dealing drugs from his yacht and, controlling some, you know. He's like, I guess he's either the dictator or just a high-ranking official in some banana republic. So, not really an admirable person, but just kind of a charming and fun character in a game like this. See, every time you think there's an alley that will save you time, you are wrong. So I'm just going to be going from one, I'm going to be going from my Ferrari to Lance's Lamborghini here shortly. I guess I could make Lance ride with us in this Ferrari and leave his Lamborghini behind. Or does he have a Ferrari? I thought he had a Lamborghini. Bobo would no. Is that the same exact car? Is that the exact same car that for some reason I think is different? Well, I can't. It looks like the car that I drove here in might have been removed from the universe because it's too close to where he parks this car. But yeah, never mind. It's a Ferrari. I think there is a Lamborghini in the game, but this is the Ferrari. It's the Infernus. I mean, they don't use the actual real names for any of these cars, but they're pretty clearly based on real cars. I just have a just style preference. I like the Comet because it looks like the Porsche 911, which was my favorite, like, super fancy car that I had a die-cast metal toy of when I was a kid. I almost ran over a prostitute. Sorry, ma'am.
I can't stand the sight of a man with such a dropped pecker.
This is a modern version, so
must be Cortez's new gun.
Until more gainful opportunities arise. They'll be here any minute. We both better get a good vantage point.
Okay. So I want to think about actually... go up there and take that vantage point, but then... just jump off and start manually shooting dudes. Like, get on ground level. Like, I don't even know if there's a point in getting on ground level, but... I'm gonna do it anyway. What the hell? That's it. No, apparently there's more. Or there's one that I'm... oh, wow, they are coming from the other direction. I'm killing way more guys than you are. Because I just jumped down here. Oh, they're going to grab the money, and now there's a chase.
My money!
All right, this is a pain in the ass.
Don't just stand there, you pricks! Chase that dickhead down!
So one more chance to lose this mission here. Gotta chase him till he wipes out.
You're on Wild Style with me, Super Rocket Mr. Magic. A very special throwdown. For those of you who are new to Vice City, this song is all about me and the Rap Attack. Pirate Radio, Wild Style. This is Houdini.
Oh my god, I think I'm having a Rap Attack.
Somebody get a doctor quick, man. She's having an attack.
She said Rap Attack, man.
Okay, probably don't want to be firing the machine gun right while the cop is there. Fuck! Fuck, 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 no, 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 no. Don't have time for this nonsense. Gotta get back after him. Oh, fuck, where'd he go? Probably need to cut across to save time. I just don't want to lose him, because that will be game over after I finally found a way that I can handle this thing with auto-aim on my side. Just really need this guy to slow down or stop or to get magically presented with a better vehicle than he has. I think we might be rendezvousing together in a way he wasn't expecting if I come up here. No. He turned the other way. So this is one of those that's real easy if you hit him early. And if you don't, you're chasing him all over the city for forever. You can get good speed going on these things, but you get wiped out. And the enemies just never freaking wipe out. They'll just go around for... well, I shouldn't say that. They will occasionally, but... particularly if it's part of the plot. But they tend to just, like, keep going forever. Come on. I'd be really annoyed if I lost it now after I finally finished the first part of that successfully. And if I start firing the gun before I'm close enough to hit him, I'm just going to create chaos for myself. Where is he now? Seems like he's close. There he is. There we go. And honestly, I'm almost out of this gun's ammo now. I should have just, I guess I should have just picked up all the ammo they dropped for a better version of this gun. Although I could have potentially run through it and been completely out of ammo. That would have been bad. Well, maybe this is unlocked as a weapon now. I might be able to buy the better stub machine gun, I think they called it. For some reason, I don't think they called it a submachine gun. I think they called it a stub machine gun. But maybe I can get a better quality Whoppet. Because these weapon drops have expired at this point, but from their corpses. Oh no, there actually is one over there. Let's go ahead and replace this. I wonder how. Yeah, well, I can pick up this one at least. 90 and 30. What do I get from this? 90 and 30. Okay, so I got a better gun now. But not the ability to replenish the ammo easily.
I live! Dickhead.
I live, dickheads.
It's all down to you. What is your name?
Tommy.
I see you soon, amigo, I think.
They didn't give him a last name. I guess I don't like him that much.
Shit. Where's that guy, Lance?
Tell me I wasn't killing enough dudes. I killed a million dudes. The dirty Sanchez. So these are the Haitian cars. These are the Cuban cars.
To the store to
but
buy
there's no there's no station in
oh. Tommy, it's Ricardo Diaz. I want to thank you for looking out for me, my man.
I don't know why I didn't just tell you this
I
in person.
I said you say you're the real deal, my friend.
The real deal, amigo.
Will you not come see me? I need a guy like you. All I have now is dickheads. Dickheads everywhere, yo. I make you real rich.
So the Cubans have these cars, similar to what they had in Grand Theft Auto 3. And there is a Spanish music station that feels right for the Cubans. The Haitians, I would think they'd listen to reggae? That's Jamaican. Maybe Haitians don't listen to reggae. I don't know, but there's no reggae station in this game. Grand Theft Auto 3, the Jamaicans, there is a reggae station. It's my favorite station in the game by far. But the Jamaicans, like in the plot, they are your enemy. They're one of the I think you do missions for them, but they betray you. In that game, you end up betraying all these people you work for. Just like anybody, whoever speaks to you is like, "Hey, I want you to betray this gang," and you just immediately do it. It's a weird game. But I believe the Jamaicans are like the only gang that freaking betrays you before you can betray them in Grand Theft Auto 3. And then in this game, the Haitians are really the only gang that are just like always your enemy. And if you play through the whole story and you're at the end, you wipe out some of the forces that you're at, like the big triumphant victory when you have, because like most Grand Theft Auto games, you can continue to play free roam and do stuff after you've won the story. But in this game, the Haitians are always your enemy. I don't really consider that a spoiler. The one time we've seen them so far, they were our enemy, and they will continue to be an enemy gang. So finally, in Grand Theft Auto 4, I know Haitian and Jamaica are two different cultures, but I mean, in my mind, they're kind of like Caribbean but not Cuban, so you know, I'm not claiming to be a cultural scholar here, but yeah, like finally in Grand Theft Auto 4 they have a character who is Jamaican who is your friend. That actually felt really good to me, because it felt like, not by design, like there's this anti-Jamaican bias just in Rockstar based on the fact that in 3 they are your enemies, but I mean, you know, somebody has to be your enemy. And the Haitians, in this game in particular, there are a few little blocks. It doesn't work like Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, where you can wipe out the territory of hostile gangs and make, like, you can actually go on turf missions and take them out. And you can reach a point in that game where, like, enemy gangs are pretty much suppressed and your gang rules San Andreas. In this game, like, Haitians will continue to spawn as enemies who will attack on site in a couple of blocks of Haitian territory, even after you are the most powerful figure in the city. Like, you run the city, you're incredibly wealthy and powerful. Like, rando Haitian thugs will always just attack you and kill you if they see you. The "you are here" thing annoys me. They really need, it's again, it's a little quality of life improvement later games give you. It really needs to be directional. Like, I need to know which direction I am moving in so I can plot my course. Anyway, I'm off on a tangent now. So, if it felt like we spent a whole mission, a whole video struggling with a mission that was actually, according to all sources, much easier than that helicopter bomb-dropping mission, then you're right, we did. But we got through it, and we unlocked a new boss, and this is actually a fairly major piece of plot progression. If you do all of Cortez's missions, Diaz is like, why don't you come see me sometime? And I'm like 90% sure if you do Cortez's mission and you don't finish Avery's missions, this happens where he tells you, come see me sometime. I got an hour, dickheads. But the actual mission where you start working for him doesn't appear. And as you can see, the mission where you start working for him is on that island that's halfway between the two main islands. So, yes, this is in fact the start of the mission chain, which will eventually unlock the whole map. I'd said something about how hospital missions and firefighter missions might be easier before unlocking the whole map. I'm not going to worry about getting them done. I might regret it later, but I'm pretty, as I thought about it more, it's like, no, they don't usually, I mean, in the missions where you're chasing someone, they can, you know, they can cross into those new sections of map, but, like, usually those, again, it's the time you're given for each mission is based on the distance you have to travel. And it's usually when you're in, like, the dense urban part of the city, and there's cars around you, and they're making you suddenly do a complete 180, and it's a big pain in the ass because you're trying to do a three-point turn or a five-point turn, and there's other cars driving around you. That's where you can lose a lot of time. Whereas if it's like, oh, it's far away, but it's on the other island, they bake in enough time. You're going full speed, more or less, across those bridges from one island to the other. That's a big, straight, easy shot most of the time. This game doesn't have realistic city traffic. So I think we're going to just keep charging ahead with the plot and unlock the next island as soon as we can. And I'm way over time, so let's worry about that next time. Bye-bye, guys.